हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू वन ऑफ योर फेवरेट चैनल्स इन फिजिक्स, फिजिक्स सर जी। एंड दिस इज द फॉलो अप टू द रिजॉल्व 8 वीडियो दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी पुट अप, राइट? एंड दिस इज द एप्लीकेशन प्रॉब्लम। एज इज कस्टमरी, एवरी टाइम वी डू अ रिजॉल्व सीरीज वीडियो, वी एंड अप टेकिंग अप एन एप्लीकेशन टू जस्ट टेस्ट आवर सेल्स वेदर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट through the resolved series. Okay, right. So this has already been posted in the previous resolved videos that I would be taking up this problem. So in case you have not yet watched that resolved 8 video, please do pause the video here, try to go forward and check that particular concept. Okay, so here's the formal wording of the question that was put up for practice at that point of time. There is a particular container which had a partition. It had a small hole of diameter capital D. Helium gas in two parts is filled up, and those two parts individually were maintained by heating the walls at constant temperatures of 150 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin respectively. You're supposed to assume helium to be ideal gas in this particular problem. So there were three questions. How does the diameter capital D determine the physical process by which the gas come to a steady state? Okay, right. So that what is the process, and that capital D, what's the role it's going to play? That's a theoretical question, right, which we have answered in the resolved video. And what is the ratio of the mean free paths? We use lambda. So in this question, he has used L1 divided by L2 between the two parts when capital D is very small. And the same question is asking in part C, where capital D is large enough compared to the mean free path. So he's asking ratio of mean free paths once the steady state is reached. Okay, so this was a question from the previous Princeton University exam, but very good potential that it can have to become a JEE advanced comprehension based question, where they give information and then they ask question about it. Okay, so you want to have a try right now, so please do that, and then you can go forward to check my solution. So here comes the solution. Right, so we are going to borrow heavily from the previous resolved videos, so I can't again keep on explaining. So in case you have missed those parts or the series, go to the playlist of resolved series. You can also find out the order in which the videos are being put up, right? So I have given numbers for each one of them. So the part A question, which discusses the idea of capital D very large compared to the characteristic length. Capital D is very large compared to the mean free path, and capital D very small compared to mean free path. Those things are called continuum flow in the first case, where D is large, right? So diameter is large. This is the type of flow you'll end up having. It's kind of a macroscopic fluid type of flow that we associate Bernoulli's principle and all that in fluid dynamics. So that kind of flow will happen. So imagine there is gas on either side of this kind of valve or hole, then the gases will flow in this particular manner in that particular problem. Okay, so they don't have a Maxwellian distribution kind of a thing that will happen across when they are traveling. Okay, whereas in capital D very small case, then that flow is called molecular flow, and it is based on a statistical idea, right? And therefore the molecules are actually, as they pass through, also collide with the walls of the valve that is connecting the two parts, or that membrane that you're talking about, or the hole that you are having in the partition, that itself will have some thickness and its walls would have some collisions. So because in this case capital D is very small, so this is the answer for the first question. Whereas in the second part, I think he's asking us to take the statistical type or molecular type of flow, and asking us whenever that equilibrium is reached, what is the value of ratio of mean free paths in each container. You should realize that in this equilibrium is established when you have number of molecules per unit time coming from right side and number of molecules per unit time coming from the left side on either side. When they exchange, balances out, that is when the statistical idea of equilibrium will come into picture. You can't define pressure during this particular situation, because remember, the pressure idea for the actual gases is based on the 3 degrees of freedom, and those 3 degrees of freedom are not allowed in this particular valve because the capital D is very, very small. So instead, it's more about the amount of gas that is going from left to right, that kind of dynamic equilibrium. So as the number of molecules going towards left and going towards right per unit time are balanced out, then the dynamic equilibrium is to be set up. Okay, so that is dependent on the collision rate, right? So imagine this orifice was closed. We have a number called as collision rate, right? So J, that is discussed in resolved 4 video. Okay, and that capital J was with lot of effort derived as n into v by 4, where n is nothing but, you might misunderstand it as number of moles. It's not. In this formula, n is number per unit volume, or called as number concentration. V is the average speed of the gas, that root 8 kT by m, right? You remember that. So that decides how many number of molecules will collide per unit area, per unit time, coming from the left side of the gas, if this was a wall. Okay, now that you have opened it, whatever that were supposed to collide will pass through. So that's the idea. Same logic comes from the right side gas, and this there will be n2 into v2 by 4. When these two are equal from both sides, then we say statistical equilibrium is set up. Okay, in this scenario, we also recall one very important formula for the mean free path, which is L is equal to 1 by root 2 pi nd square, right? So this is a formula that you are supposed to take up from NCRT textbook. And there is a reason for this particular formula, especially pi nd square is very simple. N is the number of molecules per unit volume. Root 2 itself deserves a video, and we'll be doing it soon. And it's like slightly difficult, but I think this is a formula known to us. Okay. So this 1 by n is the important factor. You see that lambda is actually inversely proportional to the number concentration, right? So number per unit volume. So the L1 divided by L2 is nothing but N2 divided by N1, which from this context is V1 by V2. You could see that, right? So V1 by V2, once they reach the either side, I can again go back to the statistical data that it's proportional to square root of temperature. Okay, so overall L1 by L2 is therefore related to root of 150 Kelvin divided by 300 Kelvin. So 1 by root 2 is the answer for the statistical, or what we call as molecular type of flow, where the diameter of the pinhole is very small. Okay, now we'll come to the C part, which is the macroscopic or fluidic, or what we call it as a continuum flow, in which equilibrium is said to be achieved when pressures are equal. Now we are assuming that the thickness of this particular wall, and compared to the diameter, whatever diameter you're taking, that itself is like a container in which the macroscopic pressure quantity is developed, and pressure should be equal on both sides. So whenever someone says that in two containers on either side the pressures are equal, that means the valve that they are using has a diameter larger than the mean free path. So this is like an inherent concept in itself. Okay, so in this type of fluidic flow, then value of L1 by L2 again is N2 by N1. So I have not changed this part, but when you write N this time, you don't use collision rate or anything. So you go back to ideal gas equation, which is valid inside that hole also, which would be PV equal to NKT, capital N is number. Okay, so number per unit volume, which is N in my present problem, it's not number of moles, is P by KT. So you could see N is inversely proportional to temperature. So ratio of N to N2 by N1 is T1 by T2. So ratio of L1 and L2 will therefore be this time equal to half. So subtle difference, you got 1 by root 2 in one case and half in another, but concept as a whole, I guess. Okay, right. So this finishes the entire setup of, I think, 3 to 4 videos we have done. So please make sure that as a revision, you go through all these 4 videos that I have listed in the description below, and ensure that you do propagate the channel in order to have more people coming into our channel, share more knowledge, and ensure that we progress as a whole, as a team, in the concepts of physics. Okay, so thanks for the company, and see you in the next video.